always feel when I come back to England, I'm back here a good part of the year, in fact. But as one goes on, one becomes, I think, the pluperfect of the has-been. And it's a terrible rip van winkle feeling about it. It's wonderful being back. Now, I went to Turkey, and there was a lot of surprise, I think, in 1995 when I did. But it was sort of, from my point of view, it was logical. The thing about English universities at that time was that you were terribly badly paid, and it became increasingly bureaucratized, and it made sense to take early retirement. And Oxford, for a brief moment, came up with an enlightened early retirement package, by which, now this translates into any language I know quite satisfactorily, by which they pay you rather badly to do not very much, and instead of that, they pay you slightly better to do nothing at all. I smoked, and so couldn't go to America, considered Germany, and responded to a conference. The Turks have been coming up over the last few years, remarkably, and there was a conference in Ankara about the Balkans, and I liked the place. First go, you know, the first thing I saw at Istanbul Airport was a row of six black uniformed policemen out of Midnight Express smoking heavily under a notice saying no smoking. And then the whole thing worked very well. The rector said, "Do you want a job?" I said, "Yes." And so it has been ever since. And I didn't know too much about Turkey when I went there. You know, the Ataturk hat law. But it has to be said, there are lots of things to read. There's some very good English books, British books. Well, no, I'll say English books, because the Scots, being sort of liberal in the Gladstone tradition, rather disapprove of the Turks and think it's all sort of rubbish heaps and multiple orgasms and this kind of thing. the English books on it are really, if you look at the Travellers Club or London Library, that wonderful institution, they've got marvellous books on the Ottoman Empire. And a lot of people, if I get talking to them, understand quite what it is. They know a lot about Turkey. There's some very curious instances of this. There was a Sunday Times journalist, maybe you remember him, called Charles Brandon, who wrote a book about the British disaster of Kutal Amara in May 1916, when about 10, maybe 15, was it, 1,000 British soldiers, some Indian, surrendered after an epic siege. They were led by a buffoon straight out of Oh, What a Lovely War, called Charles Vere Townsend, who used to occupy the telegraph machine sending love telegrams to his mistress, who was an actress in the Windmill Theatre. And this old boy, they finally surrender, having eaten the last rat. And he was carted up river in the River Tigris to Nineveh, and then on the Baghdad Railway to Adana, and then finally to be interned in the house in which subsequently Trotsky was interned, on Buigada Brinkebo. The Charles Brandon thought that the men, who had, of course, quite different fate, would hate the Turks and hate Townsend and all that, in the way I'm afraid British prisoners of war were given reason to hate the Japanese. And he expected that. What he discovered was that the 100-year-old men whom he interviewed went and spent their holidays with their prison guard back in Turkey. And this kind of thing happens all over the place. I've had a most agreeable time. Now, in the watches of the night, of course, I read these extraordinary books about Turkey. And each, the Germans have given up writing about it. I don't know what it is. They have terribly bad relations with the Turks in Germany, who are fairly disastrous. The British, the French, the Russians, curiously enough, produce very good books. The Turks produce very good books up to 1930 and then don't write their own modern history. I don't quite know why. At any rate, there's a huge amount to read. And when Tamsin Paxton said, would I do a 40,000 word survey of the Turks from, well, really, from the very beginnings to up to what's happening nowadays, I just thoroughly enjoyed doing it. None of it was a chore. I thoroughly enjoyed doing it, and I hope I'll be there for a good long time. It's obviously a country which is going somewhere. It's wonderful waking up in the morning and hearing the sound of something as old-fashioned as manufacturing. Do you remember that? you know, you get up in the morning, you don't necessarily think, well, the post's going to contain disagreeable communications of one sort or another. It's true that it's in a very confusing state at the moment. My secularist friends are all very alarmed, especially the women, that we're going to get an Islamic government. I'm less alarmed because I can see the Ottoman precedents, and particularly Abdulhamid in the late 19th century. You know that after a bit, the Islamics themselves get bored rigid by the whole thing and start cheating. So we get a new round of de-Islamicization. But it's an extremely interesting moment to be in the place, and I hope we'll be there for a long time. Thank you.